Mr. Lynn did have a good point by saying the explanation just kind of sheds light on the next administration. It's not illegal if the president does it. That's a fair point, but it's like there are a lot of things that are not illegal if a particular person does it. You know, there are a lot of things where you have a particular positional authority or a particular role that gives you the authority to do something you wouldn't otherwise be able to do. So there's, you know, being a lawyer, for example, is a good example. You know, a random person off the street cannot represent another random person off the street in court. That's illegal. But it's not illegal if I do it because I have a license to do it. You know, that's one of the things that being a lawyer gives me the right to do is represent someone else in court. So, you know, if a random person does it, it's illegal. If I do it, it's not illegal. That's a somewhat trivial example, but being president of the United States carries with it certain roles and certain job functions that, you know, give him authority by law that other people wouldn't have. So it is most decidedly the case that it's not illegal if the president does certain things because it's contemplated that he does those specific things. I mean, to put another example, it's a little trivial. If any random person tried to veto legislation, that would be illegal. But the president can do it because it's not illegal, and the president does it because he has authority. So, you know, the Nixon thing gets thrown around, but it's like, as far as what it's trying to say, I think it's actually right. And for that matter, he's not alone in this. There are, you know, basically a lot of things where a lot of people can do things they wouldn't otherwise be able to do because they're entrusted with certain authorities. So that's how I feel about that. How bad can you injure a man before it goes past assault and into attempted murder? Someone asked. So, attempted murder is not about the degree of harm. Attempted murder is about the intent behind the act. So, attempted murder is you have to have the purpose and design to commit murder. So, in principle, if I don't know, what's the most silly example that you can possibly think of? In principle, if I hit you with a pillow, but in my heart of hearts, in my deepest mind, my intention is to murder you by hitting you with a pillow, it's attempted murder. The fact that it's completely ineffective is not relevant. The attempted murder goes to the nature of the intent behind my action. So, you know, if I do something like throw a feather at you, with the right mindset, it becomes attempted murder. So it's not about the degree of harm, it's about the intent behind the act, what makes it murder. Conversely, and this does come up the other way around sometimes in law, conversely, no matter how hard I hurt you, if I don't intend to kill you, it's not attempted murder. Now, if I actually kill you, it might be murder because the legal standard is a little different for murder. So reckless conduct might work, non-intentional conduct might work. So if I actually kill you, the fact that I didn't strive to do that doesn't necessarily matter. If I did strive to do it, then it's definitely murder. But if I didn't strive to do it, it might still be murder because of the way the murder statutes are written. But if you live, no matter how bad I hurt you, in principle, if it was not my design or purpose to kill you, it's not attempted murder. Whatever else it might be, it's not attempted murder. So if I beat you within an inch of your life, if my intention was to do exactly that, it's not attempted murder because I didn't intend to kill you. So it's not about the degree of harm, it's about the mindset behind the act. That's attempted murder. And yeah, and merely thinking about something does not qualify as a crime. Fortunately, the law allows me to think about stuff. So yes, you can think about murdering someone. You can desire to kill someone. It's not illegal for you to merely think about it. If you say to in your own mind's eye, I really want to kill this guy. I really want to beat him with this pillow for the purpose of killing him. If that's what is going through your mind, but you don't actually beat him with a pillow, it's not illegal because you haven't committed the attempt yet. The attempt requires an overt act. It requires you to do something to further your intent. So fortunately for us all, mere intent is not sufficient. You have to undergo the act. So there's you're allowed to think things about people. Fortunately, thank God for that. As to child abuse or not, the statute, again, you talk about, well, it would be attempted. If the statute is attempted child abuse, then we're in the same analysis. But again, you have to separate the commission of the crime from the attempt to commit the crime. So there's a distinction in like every like criminal enterprise. There's a difference between grand theft auto and attempted grand theft auto. There's a difference between bank robbery and attempted bank robbery. You know, there's this thing happens all the time. It's only attempt if it is my design, purpose, and mental state to want to do it, if my intent is to do it. I might be committing the crime otherwise, but the attempted requires the intent. And similar, like, difference with conspiracy versus committing the crime, or accessory versus committing the crime. They're all separate things that have separate meanings. So just because, you know, just because I committed the crime doesn't mean that I am guilty of conspiracy. And just because I'm guilty of conspiracy doesn't mean that I'm guilty of the crime. There are ways to separate these concepts. You know, there are ways to fall into one and not the other. And so, yeah, that's the difference on attempt. It has to be purposeful. You have to have the objective to commit it. And as long as you do, and you commit some act in furtherance of it, it's attempted murder by its strict legal definition. Now, of course, what you can prove in court is a whole nother set of problems. But, you know, we're talking about in principle, right? So in principle, it goes this: in principle, the exact same act might be attempted murder and might not be attempted murder. If two people do literally the same thing, it might be attempted murder for one and not the other, because one had the right mental state and not the other. And that's how it goes. So you have to look at the mind's eye. And if you're saying, well, how in the heck would you determine it? That's what juries are for. That's exactly what juries are for. You lay out all the evidence and you ask the jury, hey, in their own mind at the time, did they want to do this? And if the jury says yes, then they did. That's how you solve that problem. That's exactly what juries are for. How do you determine what's in someone's mind? You ask a jury. That's what they do. So that's how that goes. So yeah, anyways, let's move on. But it was a fun discussion. Thanks for the question.